Rest. Go ahead, go ahead, go ahead. Jesse Vargas, one of the most talented young fighters in the world today. Big, big fight. Antonio DeMarco in Macau, China. Tell me about your preparations.
Well, that's right. We have a big fight up ahead, November 22nd. You know, time's winding down, and it's coming up close, you know, and we're ready. I'm very anxious to get in the ring and to start the action.
What's it like to work with Roy Jones Jr. and David Levy?
It's great. It's great. David Levy, that's my boy.
Is he here today?
No, unfortunately, he wasn't able.
Okay.
He was a little bit
but
busy.
But I see but Roy right here over your shoulder.
Busy. Here's Roy, you know, and it's great, you know, having a man with the knowledge that he has, man, it's amazing, you know, and the way he explains himself in every detail, it's amazing. You know, I'm very thankful, first of all, for him taking on the task and training me. You know, I asked him to train me, and he did, and it's actually funny how that worked out, but
how did it happen, really? Share that.
We were actually in a fundraiser at the Roy Jones Jr. Fight Academy in Las Vegas, and it was Roy Jones Jr. and I, you know, signing autographs and taking pictures for the fans for a good cause. And he just said, hey man, why don't you throw your punches this way? You know, I've seen you fight several times. For some reason, every time I tune into HBO, you're fighting. You know, why don't you do this? Why don't you do that? And at that time, I didn't mention to him that I didn't have a trainer because my trainer was actually taken off to England. He had took on a deal where he was going to be training a few guys in England, and they were offering him quite a bit of money, and I couldn't go. I told him, you know, Vegas is my home, and I can't leave. You know, this is all my support system. My fan base is here. So basically, you know, we come into this camp. It was actually very close to camp starting. Came into this camp like, shit, I'm sorry. Saying we're not going to have a trainer. Said, you know what, we're going to work hard. No matter what, everything's going to turn out the way it's supposed to, you know. But that same weekend, we meet up with Roy at the fundraiser, having no knowledge whatsoever that he was going to be there. And basically, we talk, and he says, come in tomorrow, I'll show you a few tricks. I don't want to train you. I just want to show you a few tricks. I want to see you improve. You're a world champion, and we have to continue to improve. I said, okay. I didn't mention to him I didn't have a trainer. But the first half an hour that I was there, and he was showing me so many things, like, wow, this man has a lot of knowledge, a lot to show me. And that's when I came out, and I told him, hey, you know what? I don't have a trainer. I would like for you to train me. He said, yeah, I'll train you. All right, that's not a problem, and I'm very thankful for the opportunity of training with him.
Your boxing resume is impressive. An Olympian with Mexico, a champion. How much did you pick up new things from Roy Jones Jr.? Like, because you already achieved so much.
Yeah, well, it's Roy Jones Jr. will always be known as one of the greatest and still going strong. You know, he was so different from other fighters because he did things and does things that no other fighter does. So now having him backing me up and showing me these new things that is actually are quite rare in the boxing game. You know, it's very, what can I say, it's helping me a lot, and it's making me a better fighter, you know, coming in from different angles, knowing how to attack, knowing how to defend with an attack, know how to attack and then know the steps ahead before you make them. You know, this man, not only that, but not only will he show you what you're doing wrong, what you're doing right, but you can mimic it, the exact same thing he does.